Printify is one of the best print-on-demand providers. You could open an account with them for free to sell your prints, artwork, and photos without dealing with a physical inventory. They handle billing, printing, and shipping for you. They also handle all fulfillment for you. They have a wide selection of products that you can choose from. By the way, I assume that you already set up a print-on-demand store with Printify to follow along with this tutorial. If not yet, you can sign up for an account with them for free and add a product to your store. I'll show you the next step how to integrate your Printify store with your WooCommerce store. All right, let's sign into your Printify account first. Click login. And then enter your email address and password to the login form right here. Once everything looks good, don't forget to check the box "I'm not a robot." Then click the sign in button at the bottom. Here is the dashboard of your Printify account. Just let's close out that box. We don't need that box. Click on the drop-down arrow on the top right to select your store. And we're gonna use the demo store right here to connect to our WooCommerce store. You could see the connect button right there. If you click on the gear icon, you could go to the store settings to change the name of your store right here, whatever you want, as long as it's meaningful. We're not gonna go over other store settings in this tutorial. Click save if you're happy with the name. You should be back on your products page. Click the drop-down arrow on the top right and click Manage My Stores to go back to the list of your stores. And that's our demo store. Right now, the demo store is unconnected. So next, click the connect button to start to connect the Printify store to your WooCommerce store. Then click the connect button for WooCommerce. Enter your website name in this box. I need to go back to my demo store to copy the website name. Then go back to Printify to paste the URL or the website name in that box. Paste it right there. Click the connect button once done. Next, you should be able to see the next page about Printify asking you to give them permission to have read and write access to the following of your WooCommerce store: create webhooks, view and manage coupons, view and manage customers, view and manage orders and sales reports, view and manage products, make sure logged in is you as an admin, and then just click the approve button. You should be able to come back to your store homepage. You should see the name of your store on the top right. Then click my products link on top to see the list of your products. Here is the list of your products. Well, these products are for the demo store. You could check the select all box right there to select all of them and click the publish button at one time. And then you can also uncheck the select all box too, just to unselect all of them. As you could see all the products right now, they are unpublished. So you could click on the paintbrush icon right there to edit the art file. Let's get out of here. Let's go back to the products main page. All right, here's how to publish or push a product to your WooCommerce store. Just click the unpublish button of a product. And then you will get to this page. You could select all the images right here, which one you want to display on the store. Mostly they will be selected by default. Just click right here to edit a product title. Just enter or add whatever you want to attract your customers about that product. Let's add a few words here. And when you click in this box, This box is for description. Let me correct some typos. And then you just add whatever you want there. And for this section is for pricing for different variants. Just click to expand it. Click into that box to correct or enter your own retail price. And you will see in the next box right to it for the profit that you will earn. And then the next section is for store details. Make sure you don't check the box to hide this product in the store, and then just click the publish button once everything looks good. Next, you should see the publishing button for that product because it is still pushing that product to your WooCommerce store. It doesn't take that long though. Once it's published successfully, you should see the green publish button just like that. Let's go to the demo store to check if this phone case is there. Let's refresh it. You don't have to refresh it. That's fine. Click products. And yep, it's right there on the top row. Click on the title of that product. As of right now, it's still uncategorized. Then you could edit the product. Always make sure you edit your product again on your website and update it. Don't forget to check the product title and description. Make sure you assign your product to the right category here. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you find it helpful somehow so you can help other people to find my content too. I would appreciate your support a lot. Thank you! And then add a few tags to make your product searchable in your store. When you're done adding a product tag each time, you could press the enter key on your keyboard or just click the add button located right after its box. Product tags are descriptive tags put on products to help organize and track them throughout your store or shipment. And then scroll down a little bit to add more information about the size of the product. If you have a specific box to add the size information, I do, so I'm gonna add something here. And then scroll down a little bit to add the product short description that will show on top of your product page right there. Always make sure to double check your grammar and typos here. Once everything looks good, just scroll up to the top a little bit to click on the update button on the right. All right, our product is updated now. Let's go to the front end of the demo store to check the results. Click shop to see the result. That's the phone case that got pushed from the Printify store to my demo store. Let's ignore that warning message because I got so many testing stuff going on in my demo store. But let's check on the information that we updated. Right here, the phone models all correct. And the pictures that got pushed from the Printify store, they're all right there. And information in this section, it's all correct. Always make sure to click each tab to check the product information in this section to make sure you get everything right. And for the short description, it's on the top. That's all for today's tutorial. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think about using Printify as your print-on-demand provider to create a custom print online store to make money online, and would love to share your thoughts with our community. I would love to hear about them a lot. All right, you guys have a wonderful day wherever you are. I'll see you in my next video. Bye now.